Hi guys, this is going to be a little show that I'm putting together for once a week to round up my week for you guys at home. It's just going to be me playing through a bunch of random video clips that have happened that week, some things that I find funny, some things I want to clear up or just like talk about. This is where I'm going to do it. Let's hit it! This week. It's funny because we're in this lockdown situation and obviously we're all stuck at home, we can't really go and do anything. But it seems like I've been busier than ever. So I did a live stream with Alesso.
Yeah, I've been playing a lot of Fortnite at the minute.
Playing a lot of Fortnite at the minute. Jeez. Another highlight of the week, the Travis Scott concert on Fortnite. Travis Scott. Like, I didn't think I'd feel the way that I did about it. It was unbelievable. Like, it inspired me to want to go and like make something. I mean, obviously afterwards I made nothing. Nothing did happen.
Me is like too serious, like I'm not like
Call of Duty is too serious. I can't deal with it. I just die.
That Fortnite's a bit like cartoon.
It is, but I just couldn't keep, I could never get the whole building part. I know how to build, but like when people build and edit and shoot through it.
So yeah, we had a little on screen with Alesso, which was good. I feel like our relationship has been blossoming this whole time. Like we're really getting to know each other and like each other, which is fun. And he's very, very funny, but it's the things he says off screen that I find the funniest, to be honest with you. We had Niall go on live stream and I sat there for, I want to say 15 minutes. Whenever Niall has an instrument in his hand and starts playing, like he has this face where he looks at you like this and he's playing his instrument. I'll play a little bit higher. Nothing goes past the eyes or the ears. Whatever he's doing, he's doing. So he had a guitar and a piano in his hand. And it was a tough moment. I was panicking, I was worrying. I was saying, "Niall, can you hear me?" And I asked if I was invisible. Could have been. And then finally we did get on.
I actually felt like a fan at that point then, because I was trying to get onto you and I was like, trying like, "Niall, please notice me."
Oh, you're saying that's what you were saying. I need to have a look. I'm sure there's loads of videos.
I said once you've got an instrument in your hands, I've got no chance. The quarantine moth.
Yeah.
Everyone else has gone for the quarantine crop.
You know when it starts flicking out at the back, you know you're getting.
Yeah, this bit here is like this bit's where it gets real.
Oh yeah, I mean the hair has been. I mean the hair has just been. This has been a whole moment in my life right now, because I haven't had long hair since I had that like weird like curly afro thing that I had during, was it the Take Me Home era? But it was nice to speak to Niall. It's always fun, and I feel like there's a little bit of you that kind of reverts back to like you when you were in the band. It's a nice moment. I like talking to people. It's good. It's been a lot more recently as well, you'll be happy to know. Also this week and last week, James Corden performance that we did. This was complicated to film, this was hard. I mean, the hardest thing about quarantine life in my position and job is trying to make things look interesting from home. Now, programming a drone to go around your house and, you know, and film a performance is really hard. There's a lot of thin walkways and stuff in this house, and obviously going outside we were worried about the neighbors watching on. There was like some random woman over there having a glass of wine at whatever time in the afternoon. No judgment.
I'm gonna have such a good day today. You should too. Hope you have a good day today.
Just like watching it, I mean, shouting, singing on my balcony, which is just weird, like, but we do what we have to do. So here it is, here's the James Corden performance. And for I'm quite proud that we got this done. This is pretty cool in the end. Come on, man. Okay, so something a little bit more, just a little more serious now. Obviously, we're all going through COVID at the moment, which is terrible. It's been 2 months, I think, I've been at home now, which has been crazy. Just be close to people around you, because you know, you'll know someone who's a little bit alone or someone who's struggling with it. Someone's finding it harder than you, maybe, I don't know. And just as simple as getting in touch with someone and, you know, just making yourself known and making them not feel on their own is, you know, something nice to do for people. It's a really quick, easy thing for you to do. Staying in touch with our parents, you know, that for those of us like me who live away from my parents, it's always hard for them. You know, just having a little bit more understanding at this time, I think, is the thing. One of the first things that happened in the UK, I don't know, you know, wherever you guys are from, there might have been different problems at the start. One of our first issues was food shopping. You couldn't get in the queue on any of the shops. You couldn't book a time slot. You couldn't really go to the shops because you had to stay at home, and it was all complicated. It was queuing and all this sort of stuff. And I was like, oh. And then I stopped for a second and I was thinking about how lucky I am to be in a position where I can, you know, shop for food. And I was thinking, how about all the people at this time who don't have an option to get food? You know, all these people that are losing their jobs and losing wages. I got involved with a thing called the Trussell Trust. For those of you who don't know, the info is all on my page. There's great food bank that are helping out at this time and have been helping out the whole time as well. So I thought I'd go down and pay them a visit and find out a little bit more about this charity that I just got involved with. And it was a great visit. You can see here pictures of me. I'm just packaging up stuff for homeless people it was at this hour. And the beautiful people in the background there who are helping out. You know, it's amazing to see, you know, people genuinely giving up their time and helping people out. Small layers of you know, stuff that we can do for each other. We can actually really help some people. You know, it might be small to you, but it might make a big difference to somebody else. So please stay safe. We have A Decade of Liam Payne by Ziam Somnia. This is a very tired, Liam and Zane fan, I think. Let's run it down. 2010. Okay, we've got the mop hair going on. The plaid shirts. I'm not actually quite sure how to say that. Let me know down below. This is the curly hair era I was talking about, that I had this curly hair afro. So it's been 9 years. Very serious. We've got 2012. I'm starting to become very unserious here. Terrible shirt choice on the left hand side, but what can we do about that now? The working out more era, I think this is. I'm looking a little bit more trim there. So we had Take Me Home. Was up all night the first one. 2014 here, this is the Funky Butter era, and I've gone for a Butter pose. We're shooting the album catalog in someone's garden. We have hats with a big quiff. I hate this smile that I do on the left-hand side of the clip, where I'm like, it's almost like my smile like takes me backwards. Like, I can't like, it's like this smile hits, I'm like, this year's noir. Love feels best. And a very moody little pose going on there. We got this Strip That Down era. That was good. And I'm sure I'm telling the guy take the picture to not take a picture. He's a friend of mine, it's like a common joke with us. But like, how many faces in pictures can you have? Like, I feel like I have like three main faces, which is like half smirk. There's one that's like, laughing face, like, and then there's one that's just like, I don't know what else to do. Is there a photography choreographer? Anyway, you get something new, then you like, you overwear it. I had those glasses on for a week. Does that mean I have to like wait like 2 weeks? This is me today, this is where we are. Yeah. I look like what I look like. Thank you at Ziam Somnia for that bit. I hope you're all enjoying this all. I don't even know what this really is yet, but I'm just like making it as we go. Okay. Here is Liam Payne as teacups. I mean, first off, really enjoyed that photo shoot. It was great fun, but that is me as that teacup. My arm is even acting as the handle. Next, Liam Payne as Flynn Rider. Now, I don't know who Flynn Rider is. That's me as that guy. But that is me as him. The little beard, the way they're parting. That's just the bike rack. Haircut, so yeah. So you can just funny posts in general. Here we go. Okay, first off, why? With a clarinet in his underpants. Let's just watch it one more time because it's that great. I see this thing as green and white. How has anyone seen that as pink? Okay, So I have a habit of over-mentioning a bunch of things sometimes. It's just because I don't know what else to say. I get stuck. I'm sorry. It is what it is. Louis actually texts me on my phone saying, if you mention it one more time, I'm going to egg your house. This is a picture of him that someone's made of a Ring doorbell cam and him egging my house. Yeah, it's a good thing. Thank you. It's Jasmine Charlie. I've got something I need to clear up. First off, I noticed a load of fans from different fan bases were memeing my face on things with like funny like little quotes or, you know, little funny things that they're thinking, or like they're the opposite. And like I say, at first I thought, I was like, oh wow, like, people use my face. This is nice. This is a nice thought. Like, this was, oh nice. No. Everyone's out there, they're being all ironic, and one of them said, do you ever poop in your sleep? And then the next phase of it was that I'm suing people. Now, I don't even know if this is the thing. Can you sue somebody for a meme? Do you even meme, bro? Okay, it's looking more like a thing. Okay, the first one's a cat. So this, I don't know how, there's two cats in fact. It's Keyboard Cat and Yan Cat, who looks like the celebrity cats paired up to strike a blow for intellectual property rights, and they won. Okay, like, it's just a funny picture of your face, but as long as you find it funny and whatever, it's funny. I find them funny too. I understand it. I get it. I hope you enjoyed this. I'm not really sure what this show is or what this kind of thing's about yet, but I'm going to try and do them more often. So please send me in more things that you'd like me to talk about on the show, or to hear my thoughts on questions, anything you guys. And this is away from normal interview space or anything like that. This is, you know, this is strictly from my desk. So, you know, it's coming from me. COVID's happening right now. Once again, I'm staying inside. Help out any way you can, even by helping friends and family. And that's how we're going to get through all of this this business together. But thank you for watching, and I hope that you had some laughs looking over some stuff. And yeah, thank you for tuning in to me all week. So thank you.